Hello guys, okay, so open Krita, select create new file. Once you have selected create new file, you could easily start creating a logo. So here, select that paintbrush, which is actually on ink, and then select that left tool, it's a brazier tool. You could delete or add a new layer and adjust on top the pixel size of your brush stroke. So you need to be sure that you've selected that. Okay, so let's see what to do here. We're designing a logo, and it's gonna be just a simple one, but you're gonna learn the fundamentals and the basics. So there, you need to also remember to select a bright color on the triangle select tool. So let's create a logo with the tool that you've selected on your left hand side. It's very easy to draw. You can just select the place where you want the line to form and point at another place where you want the line to connect, and once you link them up, it forms a solid line. Even if you can make a mistake, you could just press Ctrl Z, that's like undo. Okay, so I'll zooming in and zooming out using my mouse. Well, it's actually great to have a mouse, or you could actually check the zoom in and zoom out function on the bottom side of your screen. I think it's on the right side. So of course I chose a triangle and didn't actually suit, so I'm just doing that. Okay, let's add a new layer. I'll delete that one to just make it transparent. Let's add a new layer and drop it down below the one that we have drawn, the line that we have made. So select F on the press F on the on your keyboard, or select the fill tool, which is like a baguette dropping ink. Make sure that you're dropping the ink on the layer that you've put below. So I was just there trying to switch off the layers to see what I want to keep and delete. So I deleted the outline that we made, but we still have a beautiful kind of abstract like shape. So there, I selected the circle tool, and I saw that the properties were on fill, so I was supposed to change that to get the outcome that I wanted. So I'm playing around with the colors there, and I'm gonna go and try to change the fill settings of the circle that I have. So let's drop down that air and then go to the circle settings. There we go, that's the fill setting, and you can just add no fill and it'll just create a normal circle. So remember, we made a new layer where we placed the circle so that we could actually easily control it once we place the move tool, which is on the left hand side. That's where we find the fill tool. Let's add also a new layer and select slightly darker color, where we're gonna drop some ink on the circle that we've made. So just drop that, and but with this we can actually easily delete the circle outline to just have the color that we wanted to have. So there, that's how you get that cool shape. Let's delete those unnecessary layers right now. They're just like they're out of the picture. They should put them out of the picture. So I deleted that, and an easy way to add some shading, it's you gotta select the filter tool. It's GMS something filter tool, the thing that I selected. So it'll give you a lot of options. So you need to select on the shadows, layers and shadows. So select that drop down 3D shadow. You can see that it has some cool effects there. It's putting on something of a shadow, so that's how it appeared as if it's in some kind of form of 3D. Okay, so you can also add another layer and drop it down. Okay, so this layer we can isolate it so that we can only have this layer where we can drop the ink. So click F on the keyboard and do that. And you can isolate it so that you can actually feel that. And let's trim this, it's kind of huge. I don't really want to add layers so that you can move this easily. So what I'll do there is select the whole triangle tool, guys, and then trim the kind of selection. So that's how I do the trim. And once I've done that, I can select the symbol layer that's the text, and then drag inside so that I could have the pop-up text option where I could write my my text and select the font that I have. So it's actually necessary to for you to actually have a lot of fonts so that you could actually play around with the font size, or not just the font size, but then the type of the font that you're using. So there, I was changing the type of font that I was using. I was gonna go for Century Gothic. It's one of my favorite. I urge you to download this font. You're gonna love it. Okay, so this is done. Let's change the color to white. I'm thinking white is actually good because it's kind of dark. Based on the background, white suits fine. So let's select the move tool and move that a bit. Okay, I think it's nice. I'm just zooming in and zooming out to see if it's where we want it to be. So it's a very simple logo. This is just around 7 minutes. Okay, so let's try making the. Okay, don't forget to change the paint, the vector area to paint. You can get it to paint first. Once you do that, that's when you'll be able to edit the text and cut it down. Of course, you can actually cut down the vector. So there, I'll separate Control E to make the layers of the logo symbol that we made, and I also select the flip cutting to see or highlight on the left side. So once I connected that, I was able to move the A so that it should seem like it has been cut. So that was just the concept that I had in my head. I was like, okay, maybe this would be interesting, just not just make it quiet. So I'm seeing that everything is done here. So what we need to do right now is try to save. I'll press file and then save as. So once you press file and save as, you can save as the Krita document. So let me just look at the folder where I like saving my stuff. So you could actually see I've made a lot of things which have run, a lot of things that I haven't even uploaded yet, but I will. So you could actually press save as PNG, and then once you're done, you're done. That's okay. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos on how you could actually create your very own unique looking logo using Krita.